So, been looking at some of the things on our YouTube account. A lot of people want bios on who we are and what we're doing. Well, my name's Keith. This is my bio. I was born in Amarillo, Texas, grew up in the panhandle of Texas to a ranching family, ranching and farming, and grew up as a ranch boy up in southern Colorado, always around the mountains and the plains, the high plains of the United States. And grew up in a really western world in the 70s and 80s in rural southern Colorado and in the Texas panhandle. That was the only life I knew, was horses and cattle, and we had to be self-sufficient and be able to get things done, and that's how I grew up. I grew up around a bunch of men like that. We didn't have TV growing up. What little TV we did have was very limited, so we had AM radio. And so that's just kind of a little background of the world I grew up in. Got out of high school, made bad grades during school, didn't do really well in school, and got out of school, went to work for some ranchers, and knew that I didn't want to stay working for people, and I started a company doing utility work and stuff like that when I was 20, 21 years old, $7,500 loan from the bank, and from that point, I built several companies up over the last 20, 25 years, and one company failed and I had to start all over. I never filed bankruptcy, but I had to start all over, paid my bills, and I started again. And from my failures, I learned how to have some success. The pursuit of money was one of the things that I chased after in my 20s because I thought that's what would make me happy, and it wasn't. But in my second company, when I started over again, when I was 29, 30 years old, we had some pretty decent success with that. And all the goal that I had was to get back to owning my own ranch one day. That's all I wanted, was to be out on a ranch again, and I love the ranch. I also love the ocean. One of the things, when I did have TV or when we did see TV, I love Jacques Cousteau. I love watching Jacques Cousteau on TV. I love the oceans. I didn't like the beaches. I didn't like tourist traps. I don't like lots of people, but I love the oceans. I love those scuba diving adventures. I grew up reading lots of books, and my imagination was running wild with adventures, and I always loved adventure, and I love the ocean. I don't know as much about the ocean as I do the other things, but started those companies, failed one, started another one, and that company's success has gotten me to where I can do some of the things I've done. I've been able to buy a small acreage in Montana, and we call it the ranch, but it's just a small plot of land and a little cabin, and we still have that. We've sold our places in Dallas and a lot of our stuff in Dallas, and trying to get out of Dallas. That's just not where we want to be. It's not the life I want. And then one of the other things, growing up, I loved airplanes. I loved aviation. That was the other love of my life, was aviation. And I'm a helicopter pilot and a commercial instrument-rated helicopter pilot and a commercial instrument-rated multi-engine airplane pilot. And I've flown all over the United States and mountains and helicopters, flown all the way to the Yukon territories and helicopters, and flown in weather and all kinds of things. I'm kind of a do-it-yourself guy. And so those are the things that a lot of people don't know, and they see me out here on the sailboat, and they see the things that I'm doing, and they think I'm crazy or I'm careless. Well, I do have five kids. My oldest daughter's not with us. She's working, and she's 20 years old. She's working some things out in her life and trying to figure out what she wants to do in her life, and we wanted her to come on this journey. She'll probably visit us from time to time, and I look forward to that, but she's just doing her own thing and figuring that out right now in her life, and I'm proud of her for doing that. Back to my bio. I married Renee 16 years ago, and we've had these children. They've been wonderful, and about 5 or 6 years ago, I came to the epiphany that money and wealth wasn't it. It's not what makes me happy. There's nothing on the other side of money. I've said that saying many times to my friends, and a lot of people don't understand that. I have a lot of friends that money is the only thing. I mean, the measurement of wealth is everything. And of course, a lot of people can say, well, that's easy for you to say, Keith, because you've got a little money. And I do have a little money. I don't have a lot of money, but I have a little money. I mean, I have to be very careful, because probably when this adventure is over, I got to go back to work. I got to figure out what I'm going to do with the little money that I have left, and reinvest that, and start over again. We asked the children when we started liquidating our stuff in Dallas, where do you want to go? Do you want to go to the ranch, or do you want to go sell around the world? And they all wanted to go sell around the world because there was no internet in on a ranch. We don't have internet. We don't have TV up there. We like the quietness of the place and the solitude. And so they decided they wanted to go sail around the world. So we started buying, we bought the boat. We're learning how to sail. And the sailing part is easy. The navigation is easy. You know, safety and having safety, that's, you know, you just got to be kind. I'm a very conservative pilot. I'm very conservative at everything I do. And obviously I have my children's lives in my hands. And the only way we can learn is by doing. And obviously we read a lot. We've hired captains, we've went out, we've done things, and you know, I'd like to know more. I wish I hadn't thousands of miles worth of experience sailing, but I don't. And if I had that, then I probably wouldn't want to do what I'm doing. A lot of people think we're careless, and you know, I could play it safe, and I could go raise my children in a four-bedroom or in a four-walled house, and we could all grow old and die, and they would still just not have any adventure. Me and Renee, we know that there's a chance that we could lose a kid. We could get in a bad storm. We could all die. Ocean can kill you. We know that. We realize that. And it's not just all fun and games and happy-go-lucky. I mean, it's been thought about. And what do you do? And what's your backup plan? And where are you going to go? And how are you going to get out of this? And mitigate those dangers and mitigate the risk to our children. Because can we live with losing a child? And we've asked each other that. And you know, we probably can't. But can we live sitting in a place that's safe and comfortable and never experienced in life? I can't live with that. So I'm gonna have to choose which one has more misery to it that I think I can live without or with. So that's what I'm doing, and that's what Renee's doing. And I want my children to be ready to go. And do they have a choice? They did have a choice. I offered them the choice to go to Montana and live a safe, quiet life on the ranch. And they wanted to do this, and then I told them the risks of this, and they understand the risks, and they understand what it is. And so we're right in the middle of peak hurricane season going into August, September, October. We're going to have to make sure we have hurricane holes. We'll be checking the weather. We're not going to do foolish things. We're going to try not to, and we'll probably make some foolish decisions. And hopefully we're luckier than we are skilled at this point. You know, when you're flying, and you're flying in the mountains, and you're flying helicopters, and fires and or whatever you're doing in the mountains, and any pilot will tell you, you have those oh crap moments, and in those moments you learn so much, and you just hope you have enough of those oh crap moments that you can make it out of those and you survive, and that gives you that experience not to do that again. And so we're gonna have to do that with this boat. We're gonna try to sell in fair weather. We're gonna be very cautious, very conservative, but the main thing is that we have thought about this. This isn't a fly-by-night thing. We're just trying to make this work, trying to show my children that anything is possible, any adventure. You can do anything you want to do. And that's what we're going to do. And we're so honored by everybody who's following along. We did the YouTube thing so our family could follow along. And all of a sudden, we've got all these people that are following us, and it's like, holy cow. Look at all these people, and they're just—it's just unbelievable. It's magical, and we're very, very honored that people would watch us. And obviously, you have the haters out there, and the people who think you're an idiot. And you know what? I am an idiot sometimes. It's just the way it is. Anyway, I hope late next week we get out of here, and we can start sailing. Almost everything's done on the boat. The generator seems to be fixed. But once again, you may not know it, but I'm the kind of guy who can figure things out, and I try to figure a lot of things out, and I try to make things happen. And you know, I've built two companies, three companies, and I've had some success in the business world figuring things out. I never went to college, didn't have no rich dad, had to bootstrap everything I ever did, and here we are. And you know, when we're done, we're gonna sell the boat, go to Montana, and live out a quiet, peaceful life up there. And that's just a little bit about me. You know, I love my children, I love my family. I recognize the huge risk to my children and my family, and we have to be careful. We have to mitigate those risks. And we appreciate everybody's input, everybody's advice. You know, in the end, the decisions we'll make, if we hit a hurricane or there's a big storm coming, I'll park this boat, I'll fly my kids and family out of there so fast, and we'll let God take care of the boat, and we'll go be in Montana, and the insurance company can write a check, because nothing's worth the risk of my family. And that's just where we're at. This is all about my family, my children, and giving them something greater than they'll ever get just living a 9-to-5 job. And we appreciate everybody watching, and that's just my bio. I know I ramble on and I get to talking, so thank you so much.